Okay, have everyone. So today we have a wrap, right? And teacher have taught you about the if-else statement and for loop. So we will not just for loop, we also have a while loop, right? So today we will focus on practicing using if-else and any loop. But I will hint you that most of the lab that we're gonna do today use for loop mostly. Okay, let's start. We have a question you to do. The first one is, you write a C program that input a single character and you tell it is an alphabet, a digit, or a special character. You will use the knowledge about period left to do this question. Second is write a C program to give a result of GCD, the gadget, common divisor, or holomorph for the to input number. This is the same that I give you a lab in the flowchart. You can use your flowchart that you answer me back there to create a C program. The third question is quite tricky. You will show the palm number between the, starting from number two to input integer. And I have a rule that the result must only display 10 number per row. So the first one I say 10, you have to find the number is a palm starting to from 2 to 10. So basically it's a output 2, 3, 5, 7, right? But if I ask you to, if I input you 40, and you have to find a palm number starting from 2 to 40. It's have a 12 number, that is a 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37. And it's have more than 10 number. So you have to divide the to be two line. That is the first line output only 10 number and the rest is second line. So basically if you have a 40 output, so to answer me four line, because this line have only 10 number. The fourth question is, you check that this number that I give you, the three number represent the side of triangle can form a triangle. So basically, so someone who don't know how about to check it, they have a mathematical rule that if two lines have the summation of two lines is greater than the less, it will be form a triangle. But if it equal or less than greater, is can't form the triangle. So basically I say that if I input 3, 4, 6, it can form a triangle. But if I input 5, 15, it can't form a triangle because plus 5 is 15. It's not greater than the less. So it can't form a triangle. For the fifth question, you will give me the summation of the following series, that is 9. Plus 99, plus 999, so on, to the same as the input number. So basically, if I ask you to, if I ask input 3, you have to output 1,107 because it's equal to 9 plus 99 plus 999. The same as input 5, output is 111105 because it's a 39, and so on. The sixth question. And I have give you a hint, some hint that this one is quite tricky. You use you will be change a question a little bit when you're thinking. The sixth one is you give a list of number and ending with zero, and you find the average of it. So basically, but you don't count zero as a count. So basically, if I input 4, 7, 9, 10, 12, and I following with zero, it means that find the sum and average of this following number 4, 7, 9, 10, 12. So basically you find summation of this 5 number and divide by 5, you will get average. The same as here, you input 7, 23, -2, 4, 19, 22, 31, and following with 0. So basically it means that you find the summation, summation of following number, the 7 number, find the summation and divide by 7, you get the output. And if the output have really large decimal, you only show the last two decimal. The seventh question, I ask you that if I giving a number, you tell me it's a palm number or not. It's the same as the first flowchart that we did. You can use the flowchart that you did to answer this question. And the last two question is quite have a story. That is the first one is I tell you about the gate pyramid of Jesus. That is the largest pyramid in Egypt, right? Is the owner by the fourth dynasty, Pharaoh Khufu. is what built in 26th century before century, and is built around 27 year. It's the greatest state, and the last get 7 wonder in the world. So me, Pitam, want to be best pharaoh in CPE. So I need a pyramid also. So help me create a pyramid that I ask you to get input in. That is the four, the number of four in the pyramid. So you create a pyramid with a tourist, that is input five. You create a pyramid that have the five for following by the arteries. So if I argue nine, you have to create a pyramid a 9-4, and I'll put in the your terminal with this following image, following UI or whatever. And the last question is, I think it's not cool enough to just create a pyramid that is following by the arteries. I need something much more cool than that. So you create a pyramid that have label each four. So the top one is number one, the second one is number two, the third one is number three. So basically it's the same as the last question, but you have to change from arteries to be a number that represent each four. So this is all the questions we have today, my question. If anyone have a question, you can chat on me or open your mind or something like that. If you not understand each question, you want me to repeat again, you can ask me also. The question number four that have some student are that is have to be a Pythagoras or not. It's not. You just following my hint that it will be any triangle or not. And use my hint to answer the question.
Before you will try to do this lab, right? There are 9 questions here. As I just told you, right? Could you please open the textbook, right? Chapter 4, and then or you use the my slide, right? And you type the programs and try to understand and learn from that program one after another. Right. I think it should be better if you start from the easiest one, right? To do single loop, right? To print out 1 to 10, right? And then and so on, right? Until you try to write a program for a break and continue. Okay. But for the one who are you are familiar with C programming, you can start the lab, no problem. But for the one who just start learning C program this semester or this term, I suggest you to try to learn from example. You may have to type every programs in the slide that I have taught to do in the morning. Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm. I think we don't have to separate into four rooms, okay? If you don't have questions, I want to show you something. Okay. When I first start trying to write a C program, right? Especially for the for loop, I will start from this, try to okay, in I, right? And then for single loop, right? Just only one loop, right? I use for this pattern. F of R I is equal to one, and then I less than or equal to 10, right? Suppose I want to run the program to print out, okay, 10, like this. Okay, I will use base here and base here, right? It's not compulsory, but I suggest you to do like this. Okay, if I use this one, so it will print. Okay, I want to print I, percent sign D, right? I normally use, and then backslash N in order to get the new line and then print I. I just want to print I like this. So, okay, I run. This is my very first program for doing loop, right? So I will print out 1, 2, 10, like this. Okay, if I want to maybe to skip some part of the loop, right? For example, if I is equal to 7, then I hide break. Okay, I'm trying to show you the program that we have done in the morning. So what does it mean by this? Okay, it will print out 1 to 10, that's right. But there is a conditional statement here to check whether I is equal to 7. When I is equal to 7, then break will do. What does it mean by break? Break will skip print F here. So when I is 7, we will not print 7. And then the control will go out to the loop and then perform the line number 14. This is what the break does. Okay, when I run, so it will print out 1, 2, 6 and skip the remaining numbers. Okay, did you get the point when you use the break? But once you change this to continue, continue means, okay, for just this one, I is equal to 7, break will perform like continue, the continue will perform like break does. It will skip print out 7 and then go out of the loop. But for continue, right, as its name, it will continue checking the condition I is still less than of 10. Because it is 8 now, and then S is still less than or equal to 10. So 8, 9, 10 will be printed out after that. So when I run this, okay, so you see 1, 2, 3, until 6, and then 7 is skipped, and then 8, 9, 10. So this is what the difference between the break and continue does. So you can use this for finding prime number, right? When you see, when you try to, when you try to perform the loop, right? To check whether it is divisible by something, right? But once you found out that it is divisible by something, right? You need to go out because it is not prime anymore, right? In order to check for prime, you have to check every number, right, that will be devised to a specified that number. If it's divisible, it's not divisible, it's still prime. But once you found out, you can find that only one number can divide the specified that number, so it will be the non-prime. Right, if you can find one, right, it's non-prime. So in order to check for the prime number, right, you may have to use two loops, right? So my suggestion is that when I write a program, right, you don't have to follow me, but I will suggest you, right, I will always like I and J, right, for this pattern, and then J from I to J less than or equal to 10, right? If I want to set up my two loop or my nested loop, we can call this kind of loop as a nested loop. Nested loop, right? A loop inside the loop, right? And then I J. So I always do like this and D, right? I try to print it out because of, if you think you are not good in thinking in about the critical thinking in the whole process, right? When once you write a program and you know you have known in advance that this program will be the what we call nested loop, right? So I suggest you to do like this to just print out the value according to the what we call the to nested loop. For this example, you can see that I print this and then I try to print. Okay, for inner loop, right? If I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 until 10, right? We will have 10 numbers for J, right? But I want to print the coordinate I and J. So I print F percent ID and percent ID like the coordinate I and J. And then I still not make it a new line. So after this for loop finish, I will the first inner loop finish, I just print / n. So when I do like this, when I run, so you see that it will be print out like what we call the matrix, right? 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, and so on, right? For the first one is I, the second coordinate is J, right? So you can see this. And once you can see this, if you want to find prime number, right? You may have to check, 2 divisible by 1, 2 divisible by 2. Okay, for prime number, right, it will not start from 1. For example, if you want to find the prime number from 2 to 10, right? And visit. So you have to check any pair of it, right? Any pair of these two numbers, right? So maybe you can start from 2, right? In order to avoid 1, because 1 can, a number can be divisible by 1 always. Okay, when you run like this, so it will be like this. Okay, you can check it out. Mm-hmm. By yourself, and sometimes I will use define. Okay, we see this define. Suppose I want to to set a constant, right, to check for the correctness of the program. For example, I would just want to find the I still don't want to get the input, right? I want to just run program and then the result will be printed out. So I don't want to get the input at the first place. So I just fix the maximum or the number, to be checked for the prime number, like let's print the prime number until 20 something. So I normally will use this to be, I will change this to be 20, but I change this to num. Like num will be all capitalized. Okay, the variable here will be all capitalized to be defined here. In order to, what does it mean by define? Define means any place of num, it will be substituted by 20, any places. So this would be very easy, right? Once you want to get 20 for num, and if for the first time we use 20, but we want to check more for the correctness of the program, maybe I change it to 40. So it will be easily because every num here will be changed to 40. This is just a way to check for the program. And maybe this one we want to avoid num. To check, we can just use, okay, maybe less than num. Right. And let's change to 10 first and then we check. And then you can check for any pair of I and J to check for the prime number. Okay, this is my suggestion how to write a program for for loop, right? Mm-hmm. Anything else? Break and continue. Okay. This one is a program to write the interest, compound interest. I copy from the textbook, so I have to delete. From now on, when you write a program, don't forget to write the what we call comments, right? Every time, right? Okay, maybe you have to put this to change this to your name and ID, right? I normally like ID, 56, blah 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 blah, 3201, 3401, something like this. Okay, and then name, right, we need to run. And then you have to explain about the, yeah. We have function prime, right? So maybe we have to add include math.h. Math.h. So if you want to use function for mathematics, for example, like how work, you have to include math.h. Pin here. Yeah. Yeah, if you fix the year to 10, okay, you can simply like 10 like this, or you can define 10 above. Mm-hmm. And then this one is to calculate for the compound interest. Okay, try to learn so there is no more warning or error. Okay, so for the first year, after the first year finished, you will get the principal and interest 1,050. And then you can use 1,050 as a principal for the next year, for the second year, so you can get the principal plus the interest of 150 and 50, and then so on, right? So after 10 years with the rate, the tax, the interest rate 5%, right? You can get the principal, okay, for 1,628. Mm-hmm. Okay. You have the chapter 4, or you can just print. That's right. Someone asked me that in this lab and further lab, you should write comment ID and name, mm-hmm, in order to specify that this code is yours. Mm-hmm. So you need to try. Okay, I will add up how to write a good program structure, right? Step by step, right? From this step and now on, you may have to try to write the both the authors of the programs and also the comments in the program. Okay, because your program is a bit complex more and more, right? So you need to write the comments for each statement that you write the programs. Okay, so please enjoy your lab. And if you have any questions, you can please feel free to ask me or P. Tam. Okay, thank you very much.